My name is Rhapsody, and welcome back to the Darkest Republic and State of the Darkest Dungeon. Oh, everyone's leveled up. I remember when they were but wee lads. How the time has passed. Alright then. Gotta steal everyone's trinkets, put them away. Whereabouts do we want to go next? Get another gunslinger's buckle? Raider's talisman is very important to me. Oh, we finally have a chance to get it. Okay, we gotta kill the formless flesh. Alright then. If we're gonna kill the formless flesh, we want some Warren's specific people. I think I'll take Clinchamp because you've got the Warren's Explorer and Scrounger, so that's a lot of scouting chance right there. And you're also gonna be basically on the same level as our other. Just in case your third slot. As our other. Thing. Other thing. You know, the other thing. The other one. Other Vestal. There we go. I knew the word. It's just buried in the back of my subconscious. Alright. We do need to start selling some trinkets, though. That is 100% always definitely true. I could sell one of my hero's rings. Yeah. Book of the Holiness I actually got so that I could sell. Specifically. Okay, I'm gonna have to sell that because there's probably some more people I'm gonna have to upgrade in order to take on this mission. So, I know I'm probably gonna have to take Starwit, because you are nice bleed across the party. Yep. Nilnin or Depwater. Cetomania makes you way worse here, Nilnin. And you've got lower bleed resist, which also makes you way worse. You do have Eagle Eye, though. Which is a huge upgrade. That's it, I think I'll take Nilnin. That should be fine, and then I just need a frontline party member. Bodcock, this could easily be Bodcock. It's Eldritch Beach, Eldritch Beach, Eldritch Beast. You are Warren's phobic, I'm not taking you then. Natural swing. I do want someone. It doesn't matter if I'm moved, because I can't be moved in the formless flesh fight. So I'm not worried about that. What I am worried about, however, is not being able to hit the actual sections. So I think I'll take Bodcock specifically because you can, if it bleeds the middle two, you can iron swan the back and you can wicked hack the front. So, you've got a lot of options, basically, is what I'm saying here. And I can battle trance, sharpen, spear you before the fight. Just making sure everyone's pretty much optimally set up. I believe you are. You're gonna have to drop illumination for dazzling light, though, because you won't be able to use illumination in your positioning. Now, I'll make sure that everyone has the higher level equipment. Yes, 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 yes. Everyone has high level abilities as well, please. Yes. You're not going to be using those. Yes. Yes. Pretty damn good. I will... Actually, you've got the setup that I was going to give you anyway. Nilnin, you're going to be my single target stunner. I'm not going to take a double target stunner, which is going to be kind of annoying for me, but that's just how I'm going to roll. You'll be taking the cudgel weight. We're also going to have to increase your bleed chance quite significantly. So where is that item I just looted? There we go. The spiked collar for extra damage and bleed skill chance. Because you need to be bleeding 100% of the time. You just don't have an option in that. You also are going to be bleeding all of the time. Now, whereabouts am I going to find? No, not that. I want the bleed amulet for you. I could give you the Bright Tambourine to try and make your stress heals a lot more effective. Honestly, I don't think I want to do that. I think I either want to increase your crit or increase your accuracy. Your accuracy is quite high already. I think I should still increase it. Let's give you a Sunring. Speaking of increasing accuracy, we're going to give you a Sunring because that's just definitely correct. But what else do I want to give you? I could try and give you the surgical gloves, but I think I'll actually just give you the Beast Slayer's ring. increase your damage specifically. And then we've got a Vestal. Anyone want to guess what the Vestal's going to be equipped with? Too late, it's already the Tome of Holy Healing and the Sacred Scroll. I don't need any more scouting chance because I have the Vestal with a Scrounger Explorer perks. Yeah, this seems pretty good to me. I want the Raider's goddamn talisman. I lost it last time against the Brigand 16 pounder and I need it back. It's very important to me. Okay, we'll double that because it's only medium. Double that. Only need one more of those. Take five of those so that I can pop one on all of my party members before the fight so that I can try and reduce the chance of them getting bled or blighted. We're gonna run into some nasty bleeds and blights, so we'll take a lot more.
The spasmodically squirming, braying, and snorting half-corpses were heaped each upon the other until at last I was rid of them. The Warrens had become a landfill of snout and hoof, gristle and bone. A mountainous, twitching mass of misshapen flesh, fusing itself together in the darkness.
Until I'm certain that I'm gonna win.
The thing is more terrible than I can describe. An incoherent jumble of organ, sinew, and bone.
Okay, this is actually a pretty nice map. I could have looted down and then gone back up if I wanted to do a long mission, but I don't really. I just want to try and make my way through this as fast as possible. Hopefully I don't run into a trap was literally going to be the continuation of that sentence.
By evil intent.
Welcome to my luck.
The way is lit. The path is clear. We require only the strength to follow it.
It should be right here. I'm three rooms away already. I do want to get a scout on it, hopefully. Okay. Got decent lighting for this. Diseased. No? Ooh, nice. Yeah, I'll roll for the kill. If that bleeds, it kills. Perfect. A kill is basically like a forever stun. Holy shit! That's a lot more damage than I ever remember you doing.
Press this advantage. Give them no quarter.
Perfect. And get on top of the healing. I guess I'm also going to be getting on top of the stress healing. Not by choice, unfortunately. Very nice.
Continue the onslaught. Destroy them all.
That is what happens when you're a beast slayer. There's not an incredible amount of things in the Warrens that can hit the back line, so I'm pretty happy with how she is right now. God damn! Strike. Do you ever not crit, buddy? Oh, no disease? No disease. Okay, this is quite sad. I'm gonna have to debilitate these as quickly as possible. Unfortunately, I don't have the barbaric yorp, so I'm just gonna kill one.
Surges as the enemy crumbles.
You single target heal yourself. I'll probably Hound's Harry across all of them, to be honest.
A powerful blow.
Hey, that bleeds enough to kill the Thunderer. That's really what I was hoping for, to be honest. Yeah, that's like plus 100% damage against Marked. Pretty bad, to be honest. Pretty damn bad. If I can kill the Flesh Eater before its turn, I'm gonna be really happy about it, but doesn't look like I will be able to. Oh, easy, perfect.
Is broken. Maintain the offensive.
Is that bleed gonna be enough? It is not. Okay, I'm gonna actually roll the stun so that I have the ability to do some stress heals and heal heals. Ah, that's right, you're gonna take less healing because of your trinket. I did forget about that.
Death by inches.
Okay, diseases harbored in the food have been removed. Thank you for the scouting chance. Damn it, I really wanted that to expand as well. Okay, hopefully I scout after this upcoming room. I did take 5 holy water specifically so that I could open a pile if I really wanted to. Turns out it really doesn't matter to me. If only we surprised them. That's exactly what I wanted right there. Oh, come on! This one had to resist? It would have died! Damn it! No disease, 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 please. I have plus 30% bleed chance! How are things resisting my bleed?
Gently. This is how a life is taken.
Make sure to kill the one that hasn't acted yet. This one is already gonna die to its bleed, so... Actually, I'm gonna single target heal again. I trust that one of my people will act before this bulbous maggot. I have to trust that another one of my people will act before the bulbous maggot, because this action isn't gonna be able to do anything to it.
Great is the weapon that cuts on its own.
Damn it. Oh, it even crit.
Killing blow.
That's kind of annoying. That was a lot of damage as well. Damn it, didn't want to kill her.
A faint hope blossoms.
Okay, this is an empty room that we're walking into. Let's hope we get the scout upwards. Okay, we did get the scout, and... It is not the boss! Interesting, I would have prepared and gone upwards immediately. Okay, the boss is downwards. We'll use our firewood, get our camping buffs on.
Circle in the dark. The battle may yet be won.
Battle trance, sharpened spear. Now, Hound's Watch to prevent us from being... ambushed during the nighttime.
The match is struck. A blazing star is born.
Okay, we'll start making our way downwards. We do have, unfortunately, an encounter before we get there. But I do have some food to heal myself up from it. A large flesh eater. I do need to kill the cultist witch first. It's my main priority, stop myself from getting outstressed. Eldritch push on the front line, that's actually quite annoying, but thankfully I debuffed my weaknesses there. Oh, come on! She's not gonna bleed. Great, now I have to hit her with another ability, which basically means I ended up wasting my last turn. My stun chance is, like, actually 10%. Alright, we're gonna heal across the party. Damn it. Damn it, damn it, damn it. I can't reduce that. I don't have a medicinal herbs to remove that now. That's really bad. How long is that for again? Oh, it's only 2 rounds. Really? I thought that was until camp. Maybe that's a different ability, or maybe it got rebalanced, but I'm pretty certain that used to be until camp. Heal across the party again. I should have just done it for the jester, though. Okay, even with our increased bleed chance, we're not bleeding often at all.
Devastating blow.
I'm quite sad about it, to be honest. Tentacle Devourer. Does a stupid amount of damage because he's marked. Great.
The bigger the beast, the greater the glory.
That's not good at all. Alright, he's gonna have to just eat a bunch of food before he goes in. Off the torch up twice.
As the light gains purchase, spirits are lifted, and purpose is made clear.
I hate that I'm gonna have to move in with a liability already, but that's just how it's gonna have to go right now.
Squirming, contorting, and ever expanding. This horror must be unmade.
Okay, very glad that it went before any of my targets, otherwise it would be healing some damage that I've done to it. Now, we resist that blight, and that's exactly why I've rolled the... Good lord! Thank you, that's what I was hoping for. That's why I've put the holy water on everyone, so that we resist as much as possible. Now, main point, bleed as much as I can. I don't want to buff the party yet. It's not necessary. This end line member here, as we use our dog treats, is going to take way more damage than the rest of them because it doesn't have any protection. Oh, nice. Crit him back to full health. Oh, God. All of those are stuns. Do I have stun resistance? I do not. Okay. We're gonna have a bunch of our party members stunned. They're all stun chances. That's real bad. Very nice. Quakes. Again, we bleed almost all of them. Another nice... Not a bleed. Kind of sad about that one, but it's fine. Heal the Jester up so that he can't get crit into oblivion. Bone Zephyr for the stun chance. And it resists. I can't imagine this one's not gonna... Whoa! Passes? Huh, apparently a Bone Zephyr in the back line actually can't do that attack. Interesting. That's actually a real weakness. Okay, they can still do
death waits that. For the slightest lapse in concentration.
Yep. So she's being crit down to death's door. It's entirely possible that she just dies immediately as soon as her turn starts. Which is pretty annoying, but there's nothing I can do about that right now. The fact that she got hit by that blight is super unlikely at 113% blight resist. But, again, nothing I can do to prevent it right now. Okay, this one has way too much protection. I'm just gonna roll the straight damage against this target. I think that'll do more damage overall than if I tried to... slow it down.
Masterfully executed.
Doing the bleed across everyone is really, really good idea. Almost always. Yep.
More blood soaks the soil, feeding the evil therein.
I figured that was gonna happen. It was pretty unfortunate. It could have happened to the Jester if I didn't heal the Jester up, so I really didn't have a great choice there. Sanguine Stroke for probably 8 or 9, yeah. This is almost certainly where we're going to kill him. Because they're doing some healing, but we're stacking stupid amounts of bleed right now. Next time these sensor sections try and act, game is over. At the very least, I get my trinkets back, and I've also recently leveled up another Vestal.
Its destruction is a small consolation.
Yeah, we've recently leveled up another Vestal, so we do have a high level Vestal at least. Existence. In fact, I think that even might have been Clinchamp, the Vestal I'm talking about, having leveled up. I would have continued exploring had she survived, but since she doesn't, I'm just going to take all of the things that I can and leave. Yeah, let's get out of here. That's okay. I think I would have traded that Vestal for the Raider's Talisman anyway, to be honest. 20% scouting chance, 2 speed, 3% crit. The trap disarm, let's face it, isn't useful at all whatsoever outside of really, really early stages of the game. It's totally worth the 100% food consumed. It's not a problem whatsoever. Okay, you've just received tetanus and you've replaced second wind with nymphomania. It's kind of annoying. Tetanus is going to need to be removed immediately.
I can still see their angry faces as they stormed the manor. But I was dead before they found me. And the letter was on its way.
Dum 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 dum. Goodbye, Clinchamp. Actually, you're the one I just leveled up. Yeah? Okay. Yeah. Unfortunately, not really an incredible amount I could have done about that. The reason I say not an incredible amount I could have done about that, and I keep saying it, is because... if someone crits on attack that puts you down to death's door and then applies a bleed or a blight to you, you don't have a chance to stop them from doing that unless they aren't your healer. Or unless they're slower than your healer and aren't your healer. So, I kind of just had to suck it up, unfortunately, on that one. It's possible, I guess, if I took Tamol instead of Bodecock, that I would have been able to use Inspiring Cry to save their life, possibly Battle Heal if I had that equipped. But the amount of damage Bodecock put out, I think, saved the party ultimately from taking a bunch of extra damage on different rolls. So that's 19 minutes and we got what we wanted there. We got what we wanted. Oh crap, another one? It's pretty good. I think maybe we just go all out and kill the Beguiling Silent immediately. So that would be... Fear of Unholy, Warren's Phobe, Nocturnal. Nocturnal's actually really bad. You're a Cove Adventurer and Fated. T'Mol, you do have On Guard. I do like On Guard, actually, and Balanced. You're an Eldritch Slayer as well. That's pretty good. You're an Eldritch Hater. Replaces Night Owl, that's fine. What I need to do right now is basically just find a good debuff party. Debuff resistance and debuff party, basically. I could easily take you with me, but you do have Tetanus, so I would have to also take Carbonell. And she does a large amount of damage. I don't know if I want to take anyone that does a significantly large amount of damage by themselves. So of course I'm going to take Secrets. That's me being dumb, but also actually what I'm going to do. Okay, you don't have balance, unfortunately, so I can take you as my front line. You are an Eldritch Hater, and that's going to be... Actually, I don't want to take you specifically, though. Hang on. I can take Bloody Shroud, and then before the boss fight, I pop the Bloody Shroud so that I increase my debuff resistance. So that I can try and just not be taken over. And pop a Holy Water on everyone. The thing is, if the leper gets taken over, the leper can immediately kill one of my own crewmates. It's that you're that powerful as a leper. So I guess my damage that I give to people, I'm gonna have to make certain is very specifically damage that is only intended for Eldritch. You're a Cove Tactician. What if I went with something like this, took you back out, took McCry, and we gave everyone stun skills. So your stun skill, you've got spiked helmet, spiked thingy, what am I talking about, helmet, and your stun skill chance, and you take your, where is it, paralyzer crest, excellent, just negative two dodge, it's pretty powerful. And you do need to increase your accuracy and damage as well. Everyone needs to increase their accuracy if they can. Your accuracy is actually quite low. I am concerned about that. I'm just not certain if I can do anything about it right now. Faton goes on the back line. Basically, we take a stunner's party. And I guess Carbonell would be some nice backline killing potential. So you would have something along the lines of probably a Sun Ring for your accuracy to be taken. Oh, no, no, no. Ancestor's Musket Ball, of course. Then we untag this, tag this. Untag this, tag this for the kills. Right. And then we'd even put you at the very back of the party. Okay, this makes a lot more sense. Put you at the back of the party. That's extra crit and damage. And then this is extra speed and accuracy. It's either that or I give you your Raider's Talisman for the extra crit and speed. But then you have no accuracy. You've got nothing boosting your accuracy at that point. Although in the Cove, there's not that many things with incredibly high dodge. It's a no. Guess what you're taking? Ba-doom! Of course you are. I don't like the idea of having two people specifically without accuracy boosts. How about I trade... I mean, this is an accuracy boost. But I'm thinking the Eldritch Slayer's Ring is going to be really important as well. The boss, let's face it, is Eldritch. No, I think this party will be fine. Okay. Chance. All companions. I only have one religious companion. I do want to unlock Prey, though. It's still pretty good. Okay. So now I know exactly what I want to do with my setup. Okay, you are... Where's my Vestal? You are going to unlock Prey, and we're going to equip it to you. Then we're also going to have everyone check their abilities. Because I know at least one of you... There we are. Doesn't have your abilities set up in the way you ought to. I'll actually give you full Toxin Trickery as well. Shadowlance. Everyone else already ought to have the highest tier. And then we'll equip the Cove. This is going to get me very close to having finished all of the bosses that I can. Yep, that'll be enough for me. That'll also be enough. Did I end up I did not end up taking the Raider's Talisman. But as much food as I can take... just in case I don't get good scouts. It's still pretty good. Because I don't actually have scouting chance on me. Yeah, I've got Cove Adventurer for negative damage, but I don't have any scouting chance. So I'm pretty much just going to have to track it to where the furthest position is. Additional herbs, take a bunch. Only one skeleton key, to be honest. It's not that important. Bandages are quite important here. A little bit of blight. Let's go.
Under the blood moon, I lured my wide-eyed prey to the pier's edge. Before she could properly appreciate her position, I clamped on a manacle, chaining her to the leering idol. A small push was sufficient to send both into the icy waters. And when at length the tide receded, jewels of the most magnificent grandeur lay scattered upon the shore.
Good god damn, this guy's a prick.
I always wondered what became of the unfortunate little whiff.
She drowned. And now I'm fighting someone entirely unrelated. You're just telling me her story, making yourself look, by the way, horrible.
The match is struck.
Certainly here.
A blazing star is born. Ambushed by foul invention.
I have to remove that debuff. It's way, way too bad. It's actually just abysmal. You can't really carry on with it.
The way is lit. The path is clear. We require only the strength to follow it.
Okay, solid surprise. Pretty happy about it. My goal ought to be just get as many of them down as I possibly can.
A decisive pummeling.
Come, what? He didn't increase his accuracy. I knew that was going to happen. On someone. All right, well, you're going to have to hit here. Thank you.
As the fiend falls, a faint hope blossoms.
Letting them have 8 turns in a row is abysmal. Like, that could just end my party immediately. You can see why right now. Yeah, I was hoping for a possible crit to get the kill there. Spearfishing. If she gets brought forward... Well, I know I'm doing party heals now. That's 100% relevant and obvious to me. Get one kill.
Destroy them all.
Whilst peppering down another. The fact that I missed that Hound's Harry was absolutely abysmal. Okay, we'll start stunning one target. Giving us some time to do some party heals, hopefully. That's not what I was really hoping for. I was thinking for a 7 across the party would be really nice. Come on! Really? Thank you.
Confidence surges as the enemy crumbles.
Oh, wow. Now that's a lot better. And we managed to get a kill afterwards as well.
Give them no quarter.
See, that fight went horribly for us and then amazingly for us. And that's pretty much how it's going to go with this party. That's a lot of crests I'm going to have to give up. You know what? I'm actually going to give up my skeleton key. Pop another torch and
the
give
light,
that up.
The promise of safety.
No surprises on them, unfortunately. Stress wave does hit despite my 30 dodge. 30 dodge isn't that high, by the way, but it is still quite high. Let's try and pepper down this target, see if I can possibly get a kill on him before his turn. It's looking unlikely. It worked out.
Maintain the offensive.
It was either that or roll the stun, pretty much. Okay, party heal again. Thank you for 7 across the crew. That's exactly what I wanted. And
a powerful blow.
We'll make sure that the stress healer is still stunned. We're gonna have to eat another Seaward Slash as a result, but it's not as bad as the results of leaving the stress healer untouched. Read him their rights. That didn't work out as well as I'd hoped. Nice. I did want to get the heal across the party, but I also did want to guarantee that I could kill her and then stun this target. Their dodge is a lot higher than I thought it would be. I'll admit that much.
Success so clearly in view. Or is it merely a trick of the light?
Oh, incredible. Okay. Euromania. Kleptomaniac is pretty bad, actually. Kleptomaniac has to be removed out of all of these. Yeah. I don't want you interacting with everything. Where are we? Goodbye, Kleptomania.
As the light gains purchase, spirits are lifted, and purpose is made clear.
It's not surprising, by the way, that I've got no scouting so far. I have absolutely no increase in scouting chance on any character whatsoever.
Another mariner? Another misfortune.
I mean, I'm sad about it, but that doesn't mean it was unlikely. This is almost certainly the boss room. In fact, I'm going to... That's why I didn't open the previous barnacle chest, by the way. I thought, it's unlikely, but it's possible that I just run into 2 shipwrecks immediately. That would be sad if I used this. Okay, I'm gonna have to actually rest in here and pretend that I'm immediately going to the boss fight afterwards.
Huddled together, furtive and vulnerable. Rats in a maze.
That is to say, pretend that I have the knowledge that I'm specifically going to. Does anyone have diseases? No, perfect. Okay, extra accuracy and dodge needs to go on someone as well. I think that needs to go on the Houndmaster. I can produce a supply item and use Sanctuary or Zealous Vigil. Neither of them actually does anything outside of just preventing the nighttime ambush.
In Radiance, may we find victory.
By the way, this is me relying very strongly on the mechanics that I think I'm certain of. That's quite annoying, actually.
Mind that such missteps are the exception and not the rule.
Because my understanding is that it's always the room that is furthest away from the spawn that has the boss. If this doesn't have the boss, I've just really horribly fucked up. Let's make sure everyone has the exact right abilities on them. Yes, yes. Yes. Ish? Yes. And yes. Okay. Let's go in. I really should have upgraded Illumination on her.
The aquatic
nice.
Devils have remade the poor girl in their image. She is their queen and their slave.
Ooh, solid resist there. Okay, let's stop. Basically DPS rushing her. Stunning her isn't that good because she has 2 different... Come on, man! Come on, he hasn't even taken his turn yet. That's really annoying. And then you're gonna devour. Well, that's fine, actually. That's really annoying. His debuff resist should be like 90-something. I was trying to remove her dodge, and unfortunately she dodged my removal of her dodge. How dare she? Pressure crash. It's actually quite annoying. Stress across the party. Nice crit for some stress heal as well. Another pressure crash. It's fine that she does pressure crash as long as she's not summoning more people. Because she can summon people on her team. I'm actually going to stun her. Try and prevent one turn from her. It's not going to be much, but it is something. And we'll use a heal on our Houndmaster preemptively. I will live forever here with my love. Damn it, that means he's going to take another turn on her team. Really couldn't dodge that one, could you? Unfortunately, he goes to the very end of the party, which is really annoying, as you might imagine. Excuse me? Your accuracy is ins- Don't you dare. Thank you. That's what we needed, resists. I'm gonna have to roll another stun, because again, I'm at the front of the party, there's nothing else I can do right now. Okay, heal up our lowest target, try and prevent her from getting mortality debuffs. Keep her accuracy as high as possible though. My stun chance is really bad, but it's still also the only good thing that I can actually roll. That's pretty good. We actually managed to stall an entire turn from her. Okay, all we need to do is that swap, and now we're back in party positioning. Perfect. Her blight resist is apparently not that high, but she did resist my debuff, which lowers her blight resist. Damn it. That's quite annoying, but at the very least, this guy is going to be able to do things from the back of the party. Okay, this is only a 45 to hit. Second time I've rolled it on a coin flip and missed. But I really wanted to decrease her dodge chance. Because if this doesn't land, I would be sad. The ground quakes. Oh, excellent. This guy has already lost his dog treat bonus. That's actually really important. If he still had his dog treat bonus, he would be a huge threat to us. High Tide is going to be summoning a creature. Thankfully, it's a relatively easy creature to kill. For the tides, kind of annoying. Oh, nice! He does stress heal. Oh, that's the least bad thing he could have done. It doesn't actually affect them at all. It's stress heal and healing himself are the two things that would be least effective. Thank you. Okay, that's a heal on yourself as well as a kill on the target. Okay, you've now got... Right, so when you come back, you buff your own debuff resistance to make it easier to dodge. Okay. Solid attack. We're almost certain to get this kill. Not right now, unfortunately. Yeah, you're almost certainly lost. What? Wow, he resisted. Nice work. Please debuff the dodge. No. Oh, I really, really ought to have upgraded that skill. 12 to 22 and rolls to 22. I'm pretty okay with that. High Tide summons... I can't believe you're not summoning the Pelagic Bulwark. Because that would actually be problematic. If you summon the Pelagic Bulwark, I would be sad about... Yeah, you're dead already.
Seafaring trade, the lifeblood of any port, can resume again now that the routes are safe.
Unfortunately, I couldn't do anything from that ability. My only ability to hit the front line is lunge and... Sorry, R. Lunge and the poison darts, both of which have to be in positions 3 and 4 to do. Battle over.
A trifling victory, but a victory nonetheless.
We'd have to do too much backtracking through corridors we've already been in order to go and visit other things, so I'm just gonna cut my losses on a bunch of the resources that I overstocked. Got Focus Ring and the Siren's Conch. Extra debuff resistance for... I mean, I always say extra this for the lower one, because usually the lower one is the cost that you pay. But no, it's just extra debuff resistance and extra stress damage resistance. Okay, Deadly replaces Cove Tactician. That's actually really good. Are you my Eagle Eye? If you are, that's really good. I don't think you are, though. Wield Scroungel replaces Balance. That's kind of annoying, though. All right.
Trouble yourself not with the cost of this crusade. Its noble end affords you broad tolerance in your choice of means.
That's some straight up boss destruction right there. We've got the Brigand 16 Pounder and the Drowned Crew left. Then an Abomination to level 6, all of the Darkest Dungeon obviously, a Highwayman, and a Plague Doctor to level 6. I think we actually have, yeah, Plague Doctor coming up, and a Highwayman who is just a single mission away from becoming level 6. Okay, sort our trinkets. Now, money is a huge priority for me right now. By which I mean I have none and I need some. So I'm going to be selling a few things that I'm certain I have double copies of that I don't need. I'm never going to be running double stunning Houndmaster. Because Houndmaster can only use stun from slots 1 and 2. And can't use Hound's Rush. Not Hound's Harry, but Hound's Rush, the single target attack from slot 1. So you never want to have one in slot 1. So I'm never going to have the opportunity to use 2 cudgel weights, basically, is the ultimate end of that story right there. I have better things than Warrior's Cat for accuracy now. Okay. That solves some of our money problems for the moment. Let's see where we'd like to go next time. So we have the option to try and go up against the Brigand 16 Pounder. I'm not certain I think that's a clever idea, just because the Brigand 16 Pounder has handed my ass to me before. Although it was complete bullshit RNG, but still, I don't know what I'm talking. I didn't say that. Why would I say that? Eldritch Hater, Will Tactician, you're a Kleptomaniac, and a Claustrophobic. Can't take you. Lucelle. Armor Tinker, Cove Adventurer, God-fearing. No, I have low-level... I have low-level abominations out the wazoo. What I need is a low-level frontline party member who isn't religious. Ooh, hard-skinned. I'm taking Puer. Yeah, I'm taking Puer. Hard skin, that's extra protection on a man-at-arms. Just imagine the EHP he'll have. It'll be insane. So we're probably going to try and do some low-level missions to try and level up Dubois and taking Puer. So it would be, I'm guessing Puer, Dubois, I guess Patrice would have to be the next, and then Sakerville. So it would have no strong heal. I'd have Sakerville probably equipping a heal to take someone off Death's Door if they need to. Dubois and Patrice both have their own single target heal. And Puer is, let's face it, not going to get down to zero health. Okay, that's almost certainly what we're going to be doing next time in Darkest Dungeon. My name has been Rhapsody. The name of the game has been Darkest Dungeon. Hopefully you've been enjoying yourself, and we'll see you next time.